Hello again, and welcome back, everyone. Today, we are going to explore an incredibly useful data structure in Python called dictionary. Dictionaries allow us to store and retrieve data in a structured way using key-value pairs. Let's dive in. A dictionary is an unordered collection of data that is accessed using keys instead of numerical indices. Each element in a dictionary consists of a key-value pair, where the key is unique and used to access its corresponding value. A dictionary is an unordered collection of data that is accessed using keys instead of numerical indices. Each element in a dictionary consists of a key-value pair, where the key is unique and used to access its corresponding value. Let's start by understanding the structure of a dictionary. Imagine you have a dictionary to store information about students. Each student's name is the key and the age is the corresponding value. In this example, we have a dictionary called StudentInfo. Each key, such as Alice and Bob, is associated with a value such as 16 and 18, respectively. To access a value in a dictionary, we use the associated key. Let's see an example. Suppose we want to retrieve the age of the student named Alice. In this code snippet, we use the key Alice to access her corresponding value, which is 16. We assign it to the variable age and print it. Using the square brackets notation, we can retrieve the value associated with a specific key in the dictionary. Dictionaries are mutable, which means we can add, modify, or remove elements. Let's take a look. Suppose we want to add a new student, Diana, with an age of 17 to our dictionary. In this code snippet, we use the key Diana and assign her age of 17. We then print the updated dictionary. By assigning a value to a new or existing key in a dictionary, we can add or modify its corresponding value. Now, let's explore a practical example where dictionaries can be handy. Imagine we're building a phone book application. We want to store the contact information of people using dictionaries. In this code snippet, we create an empty dictionary called PhoneBook. We use the names Alice, Bob, and Charlie as keys and associate them with dictionaries containing their contact information, such as phone numbers and emails. Finally, we retrieve and print the contact information of Bob. Dictionaries allow us to store complex data structures, such as nested dictionaries, which can be useful for organizing and retrieving information efficiently. The important thing for you to remember is that dictionaries are variables that store key-value pairs. We create dictionaries by writing a variable name, then an equal sign, and then in curly brackets we add as many key-value pairs as we need. We enter each key in quotes, followed by a colon, and then assign a value. The value could be a number or a string, in which case we need to put the value in quotes. The key-value pairs are separated by a comma. Accessing the value is easy. We basically write the name of the dictionary, followed by square brackets, and inside these brackets we specify the key of the value we want to access. All right, now that you know everything about dictionaries, we're already at the end of today's lesson. Next time, we'll take a look at a far more advanced structure called a function. Don't worry, we've already used functions without calling them functions, but next time we will look at how to create our own function. See you then!